Okay, good morning everybody. So I'm going to basically spend the 15 minutes that I've got by demonstrating the software that we are developing currently with Michael Clark and Peter Manning at the University of Huddersfield and Durham University. So they are sorry but they cannot be here today. Just 1 minute, however, before that to talk about the background. So this is developed within a project that is funded by the UK's AHRC, so for a duration of 30 months. I'll be very quick about that, but you've got a download and project web link at the bottom of this slide. The primary aim of this project is to thoroughly focus on the investigation of 8 case studies of the electroacoustic music repertoire. So it's basically musicology of electroacoustic music. But in addition to the study involving software development as well of these 8 case studies, we are developing a more generic tool dedicated to the electroacoustic of any the electroacoustic music and to virtually any piece that you can imagine. So of course, within this workshop today, 2 members are quite involved in very well-known software that are based on sonogram. So Yann Geslin has been involved in the Acousmograph, and Pierre, obviously, is currently developing e-analysis. So the tool that we are developing is as well a sonogram-based tool. But the first idea of this program was to, in some way, integrate it in our project so that we can easily bring some of its components into some specific cases. So it's all built in Max. And the second idea is to build from some earlier interactive oral analysis. So I have to skip about these concepts, but basically you have 2 interesting links here, and you can also visit the workshop webpage to get these links. To elaborate some analytical charts from the sonogram objects that you draw from the sonogram. So I will just launch Tiles now, and if you've got further questions, of course I'm happy to discuss afterwards, and you can still get some information from our web page. Okay, so that's what Tiles look like. You can download it as a very beta version as soon as now, but it will be refined after some user feedback is provided to us in, say, one year's time. So the first idea is to import a sound file. So I don't have time to do that, so I'll open a pre-existing project, which is blank, apart from the fact that it has a sonogram built in. So here, this is Plan et Délier by Bernard Parmigiani from the Natura Sonorum. So you've got the full 4 minutes and 20 seconds length of the file here. And the idea is to have a fully interactive sonogram that you can play like this. And maybe... Okay, I'll be quite quick on the sonogram side, but basically the idea is to first explore the sonogram content in sound. So you've got a scrub tool here that enables you to point at any time position, but also you can reduce the range in hertz of the scrub cursor so that you can actually see what's going on in sound at some particular position in time and frequency. So, of course, the sonogram is a kind of extremely primitive way of notating things, and what does the musicologist want to do is to elaborate maybe a set of objects that he thinks are relevant in the context of his analysis. So, I'll try to speak louder because I think that we've got some background now is behind us, but basically the first idea after having done this first exploratory step is to draw some objects. So for instance, you can draw rectangles, a bit like in AudioSculpt, and play objects, but the interest here is that you're playing directly from the FFT data that has been extracted from the input sound file. So if you activate shapes pass mode, you'll just hear the very content of the object in time and in frequency. So here everything else is filtered. A good point here is that you can change colors and this kind of thing, but draw three handshakes, so I have to be quite quick here, but and if some shapes overlap, you can still hear them independently, so like that. Right, so the main idea is not to stay on the sonogram world, you can spend much time on this, but then to build some charts, musicological charts, or whatever you can imagine as something that reflects your analytical views of some piece of your choice. And the idea is to go from the sonogram to a chart maker that in some way addresses the issue of presenting the results of your analysis, not on the paper in a book, as it is almost always the case, but directly from the software itself, so that you can not only show what you've been elaborating and what you are talking about, but also just directly press the associated object so that you hear immediately their contents. So in other terms, that's a kind of generalization of this principle of interactive oral analysis that I've been discussing. So there is a palette on which you can place, I just very quickly draw totally dummy shapes so that you have an idea. Okay, so now I've got a set of sound objects that I will dump on the palette. So the palette is interactive as well, you can play objects from it. And now you can go to the second window, I mean the second main window of Tiles, which is the chart maker, which is for now empty. So I'll create a new chart, which looks like this by default. The first thing that I want to do even before putting my shapes on it is to edit some general attributes, so I'll just give some name to it, and you can also change colors, you can set an initial grid and things like that. So now that I'm quite ready to do so, I just select all or some of my palette objects and put them to the chart. So here they are. And now I am ready to assemble them out of the time and frequency constraints imposed by the sonogram itself. Right, so sorry Dominique, I forgot to watch my time, but I'm
not aware. 8 minutes.
I've got 8 minutes, so that's good. So the idea is to have a kind of open-ended tool in which you can do some graphic operations, and the most important thing in that case, obviously, is that I've got an object selected here, and I can immediately play it. Hopefully you hear what is diffused, and it's just connected to the sonogram. So this is all built in Mac, so you've got a couple of, more than a couple, but some databases for chart objects, sonogram objects. I forgot to mention that obviously on the sonogram side, as a musicologist or as somebody that in general observes music, you might not want to always have to consider one single shape as a musically significant object. So you've got the possibility to group shapes together, assuming that they form a consistent unit. So here, for instance, if I go back to what I just grouped, you've got one consistent group, and so on. So the chart maker has some very basic features that enable you to draw your analysis. You can draw lines like this, you can connect objects together so that you've got these three representations. You can also put annotations on the chart, so I'll do that now. Right, so you get the idea. It's quite open-ended like this, so that the idea is to not to impose any pre-assumed analytical view on what you are doing. So there are a couple of more things, but again, check it out. There is a user manual that hopefully will help you get started. Just what I want to show to you now is the fact that you can have several charts for one single piece. So I'll just load a project that is based on the same piece by Midjourney. but for which we have a bit more than 15 minutes to elaborate a couple of analytical objects. So here basically you've got two main categories, Gleason D, that are a bit more relevant than what I just drawn. And I'll just move to the chart maker now. So you've got a paradigmatic chart here which represents the categories according to a vertical timeline. So again, you can play back any object from the chart itself. And the good point in this case is that you can create as many charts as you want. So I'll switch to another representation here. And here you've got a taxonomy with exactly the same set of objects, but that are represented under a different musicological representation. So just to conclude, let's just say that Tyholz is for now just a kind of general framework in which you've got this idea of building representations that are primarily interactive and that you can directly present to an audience in sound in addition to the visual side. But that in terms of general notation, of course, it raises many interesting perspectives. I hope we have some time to discuss it later, but obviously the fact that we build this in Max also enables the fact that we can consider the importation of MIR related libraries for drawing objects more or less automatically and things like that. So I'm quite keen to discuss any perspective on this later. So thank you very much.